everyone, and welcome to this bonus yin yoga after your 30-minute kettlebell workout. What I want you to do is find a comfortable place. You can be seated, you can be laying down, however and whatever your body needs today and at this minute. You are, for this yin yoga, going to need some props, and if you don't have official yoga props, that is okay. Feel free to grab some blankets in your house, some pillows, and that'll really help you for today's practice. To start, we are going to get into some alternate nostril breathing. And what I like to do for this is stack, should do one yoga block to kind of help. If you have a little bit of a runny nose, you may need a tissue during this process, but we're gonna spend a few minutes here just breathing and coming in, focusing on how we're feeling, how the body's feeling. Yin yoga is great to get a fascia release. It is great for an energy release. This should feel good, and we need to just listen to your body. There should be no pain. Everybody is at a different level from a bone structure, so you want to just pay attention to you and your body and all of the different alternatives I'm going to give you for each of these stretches, because it's what matters for you and how you are feeling. So we need to be mindful and listen to our body while we are going through this practice. What I want you to do first, and you can be sitting, laying, whatever's most comfortable for you, you're going to place your pointer middle finger on your nostril, left nostril, and then you'll use your thumb for your other nostril. So what you're going to do is breathe in through that right nostril right now while the left one is closed. Nice deep breathing, and then exhale. Switch fingers, switch nostrils, and exhale. Go ahead and take some time to get that breathing in, and in a couple minutes, I will give you a little more instruction. But for now, just breathe. Now, what I'm going to have you do is do counts of four. So you're going to inhale for four, hold for four, and exhale for four. So, two, three, four, hold. Two, three, four, hold. And release. Two, three, four. Go ahead at your own pace and breathe. Have another minute or two to get you through this before we go into our first yin yoga pose. let's go now for three more breaths, three more deep breathings. Into shoelace. So I'm going to show you a couple of variations for this yoga pose, and then we will be sitting here for 5 minutes and making sure that we are feeling these in the right spots and that there's no pain in the joints. So the first one is pretty easy. We're going to kind of stay in this crisscross applesauce. Your feet don't have to be tight to it at all, and we want to feel we want the glutes and a little bit of the outer thigh for this stretch. And if you need a deep stretch, a little bit deeper, you can reach forward. At the same time, you can use a prop if you want to get a little more comfortable, because you will be sitting here for some time, and fold and hold. Another variation to make sure that we're getting the glutes and the proper place without feeling the knees is to do what's called the reclined pigeon. So this can be done just by laying on your back, crossing one leg over, reaching and pulling. If you need more of a stretch, you can push this knee away and flex your toes. A great alternative as well is to prop up your, so you don't have to do so much work since we are sitting here. So prop up your leg as well. I could probably go another, a little higher, and just breathe. The third variation, if you would like to try, is then actually using the wall, a wall, and doing the same thing. So once you find a comfortable position, making sure that you're feeling, come over here, you want to make sure that you're feeling your glutes and the outside of your hips, and the intensity of that stretch you want at about a 4, 5, or 6 on a scale of 1 to 10. At no point should you feel your knees or the front of your hips. You wanna make sure that it's really focusing on the glutes. So we're gonna sit here for the next 5 minutes. I will cue you into another pose with some three deep final breaths when we get there. If you are doing this pigeon, I will also at the 2.5 minute mark, reach out to you as well.
you feel your mind start wandering, just go back to your breath. Alrighty, if you are in the supine pigeon, go ahead, take three breaths. We'll do another move to just kind of loosen everything up and then go into the other side. So three deep breaths. Slowly come out of that position. If you need to, one of my favorites is just bringing the knees side to side if that feels good for you. Sometimes I like to come up into a bridge position. Bringing the knees into the chest might be another alternative for you. And then go ahead into that position, into your pigeon, and switch legs. Once again, make sure you're feeling your glute outside of your hip. Make sure you're not feeling your knee. And breathe. Come back to your breath. Go ahead and take those three deep breaths. Finish up this move. Go ahead if you need to, maybe some cat-cow might be appropriate. Kind of get some movement back into your body before you go into the second pose. Alrighty. This next pose, we're gonna go into antler. So I'm gonna offer two variations again for this. The first one, sitting on our legs, all right? If this is uncomfortable, we wanna make sure that we're not feeling this. We're trying to target our thighs. We do not wanna feel our knees in this position. Should this be uncomfortable, one variation is to go and sit on a block, okay? And if your legs are not in line with your feet, we definitely don't wanna feel the knees in this pose. The first option is to just come through your hands and breathe, taking that slight back bend. Depending on how that feels, you might just want another variation that offers some support. So what you're going to do is take your yoga blocks. You might need a third one. And what we're going to do, one way that I like to, is, there we go, prop this up. If you need a blanket in case you get a little cold, just make sure that everything seems stable. Careful as you get into it. I am going to sit on my knees because this does feel okay. And then it's just coming back nice and slow. And this might be a good support. At no time should you feel your knees in this position. So go ahead, nice deep breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth. And we'll sit here and breathe. If you feel the need to cover yourself up with a blanket, that is okay too. Opening up. Remember, this is your practice and your body, and you know what your body needs. this time, go ahead and take 3 deep breaths. When your body's ready, use your hands to guide you out of that position, nice and slow. You may want to go into cat-cow, you may want to lay on your back, whatever feels right for your body, to just release the position that you were just in. Give yourself a minute there. Final pose for today is going to be the caterpillar, and I'll show you a couple variations of this. The first option, with your knees straight, is reaching. What we're targeting in this is the spine and the hamstrings. Depending on if you're getting that stretch of a 4, 5, or 6, you may also want to come up onto a yoga block. Help get a little more stretch in those hamstrings. You won't be able to equally stretch both of them. This might help you fold forward. In this position, you can also bring a bolster if you'd like, maybe a blanket, getting comfortable and placing your head and reaching. Whatever feels best for you and your body. The next option, we're going to do, bring, you can, we'll start with the block away. We'll go into a half butterfly and hinge. So it doesn't matter where you're at with this leg, it can be out, it can be in, whatever's comfortable. And reaching, leaning towards that side. So what we'll do again, we'll spend 2.5 minutes. I'll give you, if you chose to do one side versus the other, to help you as well. If you need to sit on a yoga block here, you're more than welcome to. If you want to bring a bolster, you can as well. And reaching for that position. I'm going to actually come off of my block. I'm going to give this one a try today, making sure that you don't feel anything in your knees. It's your spine and your hamstrings that we're targeting. And reaching for that. We're gonna hold this and I'll give you, come into your breath and breathe. Feel your mind start wandering, just come back to your breath. and take three final breaths, deep breaths. This point slowly come out. If you feel the need to, you know, just bring those legs side to side. And then if you're still, if you're both using both legs, go ahead and just stay where you're at. I'm gonna come to the other side. And just breathe. Again, hamstrings, spine. Make sure you're not in your knees with this. We're about to come to an end here, so take those three deep breaths. When you're ready and your body's ready, come out of that position. Go into our final pose of the day, Shavasana. You may want to cover yourself up with a blanket if you feel your body might be a little cold. A lot of individuals like to prop this under their knees. Comfortable for your final position and breathe. to start wiggling your toes and your hands. Bring your body back to some movement. When you feel you're ready, go ahead and roll onto your side and then back into a seated position.
Hands to our heart. Namaste. Thank you for joining me today for this yin yoga recovery after your kettlebell workout. Enjoy the rest of my day. Enjoy the rest of your day.